Assalamualaikum and what's going on guys? For this video, I will try my best to speak fully in English. And the reason I do this is because I want to improve my speaking capability and also I want to test out an experiment to see whether language barriers affect the view rates of a video and can my video reach outside Malaysia. I don't know, we hope so. Okay, the product that I will talk about today is a gaming chair, specifically Thomas Roy. And is it really a good investment for you? We'll see about that. Before we go further babbling about features, what you can do and the drawback, first thing you need to evaluate your situation, whether your current job requires you to work at home or you need to be mobilized. And if the answer is the first one, then you need to consider owning a gaming chair. Okay, let's proceed with the quirks and features that are available with this particular gaming chair. The one with me is the model named Troy from Thomas, and the price is around 799 ringgit, and it can go up to almost 1,000 ringgit Malaysia depending on its batch. This offer only stands for the availability of the stock. If you want to own a gaming chair, you might want to consider this one. Okay, first we go for the design. The design of any gaming chair is hugely inspired by a bucket seat of a racing car with extended side that act as a gripping tool to your body. The most important thing about gaming chair is how ergonomically the design is, and Thomas Troy achieved that point with a uniquely designed head and a lumbar pillow that give you the ultimate support and improve your body posture. The material for Thomas Troy is a microfiber, which Thomas call it soft cooling touch 2.0. Sounds like high tech material, right? The difference between a gaming chair and an office chair on the cushion side, where the gaming chair cushion thickness is more and not only can help to absorb the pressure of your body, which result in less fatigue, but also give you the comfortness level that you need. The back seat angle adjuster can go from a vertical 90 degree to a flat 180 degree depending on your needs. We also have the 4D armrest adjuster where it can move up and down, forward and back, and side to side with a button. The armrest also can do a swivel movement where you can angle in and angle out the rest pad. The padding on the armrest is well designed and also soft to the touch. Thomas Troy can withstand a person's weight up to 180 kg, and the minimum height is around 172 cm. If your height lower than that, it might not be suitable for you. The foundation of the seat is made out from heavy duty metal base that can accept aggressive usage from the user. One last feature that you cannot miss in considering a gaming chair is the rocking function. Once you experience this mechanism personally, you won't look for others anymore. This mechanism is like an addiction. For example, when we use a pen, like in a brainstorming ideas moment or a situation, we tend to repetitively click the pen. This action is sometimes involuntary activate, like when you bite your nails. The sound and the movement of our thumb pushing the pen tip somehow help us to generate ideas or solution during a task. Not to forget, Thomas also offers you a 3-year warranty during the ownership process of the chair. Now we talk about the drawbacks of Thomas Troy. The first one is about the armrest. Remember when I told the armrest can do the swivel movement? Yeah, it's flimsy. It wobbled enough to make you even wonder when it will break. Regarding the microfiber material, it's highly suggested that you use an air conditioner or a very powerful fan that can blow away the heat from your body. If not, your back will easily sweat. That is what happening to me right now because I'm using a small fan. I might need to consider upgrade my room to use an air conditioner. Maybe in future. For the base of the gaming chair is very heavy because it's made up from metal, and that result and very hard to move the chair around if you are on the carpet. I would suggest you buy additional floor mat for the caster wheel to move, or you just gotta make sure that your floor surface is smooth enough. And lastly, upon assembling the chair, make sure you retighten the screw at the sides of the chair. As I have been informed by the seller previously, he said that probably during the production line, they did not properly screw the side, which caused some cases to have a creaking sound when their customer use it. So the conclusion for this video, is it really worth your money? I would say yes, because at this price point and features given, you will hardly find another brand that offer you bang for the buck like what Thomas did. If your budget doesn't meet the price tag, they also have another model like Blaze X Pro, Cyric 2 and also VAC that you can consider, but those may have some slight area on each one of them. You just gotta see through the spec sheets. That's it for today. If you guys have any other questions, you can put it down below. As always, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Till we meet again, Assalamualaikum and adios.